The responses of lifelong learners in Davao del Norte State College to the new curriculum.
I'm Kenneth.
I'm Jorica.
I am Micah.
And I am Tash.
And I am RJ. Today, we will going to present the data that has been gathered by the group.
From the transition of the basic education curriculum to K-12 program up until the new general education in college, the struggle upon the lifelong learners entity is on the line. Lifelong learners collectively are the graduates who have obtained high school diplomas in school year 2014 to 2015 or earlier under the old 10-year basic education curriculum. Lifelong learners' motto may be, it's never too late to take a step upon pursuing those dreams withdrawn from the past. The Commission on Higher Education urges these learners to finish their studies. The reasons for returning to school are varied and unique as each student comes with their own life experiences and goals to achieve. This study will become a mirror that anyone should look upon, containing the thoughts and responses of our dear lifelong learners about their adaptation upon the new college curriculum that is merely pointing upon their present situation.
Variables of the study. Qualitative. The responses of the lifelong learners in Davao del Norte State College to the new curriculum. Quantitative. The ages of the 30 lifelong learners in Davao del Norte State College. The 30 lifelong learners of Davao del Norte State College were interviewed about the new curriculum, and there are only 5 responses for their survey. Strongly agree, agree, neutral, strongly disagree, and disagree. Here is the data set. Neutral, disagree, agree, disagree, neutral, disagree, disagree, neutral, strongly agree, strongly agree, agree, strongly agree, neutral, neutral, agree, agree, strongly agree, disagree, disagree, neutral, agree, agree, neutral, neutral, strongly disagree, neutral, agree, neutral, agree, and strongly agree. The ages of 30 lifelong learners in Davao del Norte State College: 25, 28, 23, 24, 21, 23, 21, 22, 22, 34, 27, 23, 23, 25, 21, 28, 30, 24, 21, 40, 21, 35, 21, 23, 22, 32, 22, 24, 20, and 21.
The formulas being used in the study. For us to get the number of class, we're going to solve 1 plus 3.322 log n. For us to get the approximate class width, we're going to solve for the range or the upper class limit minus the lower class limit divided by the number of class. In our study, we have solved for the number of class 1 plus 3.322 log 30 as the sample size equals 5.907. In our approximate class width, 40, our upper class limit, minus 20, our lower class limit, divided by 5.907, the number of class, has yielded to 3.38 or 3.
Categorical frequency table. Group frequency table.
The class interval in our study is 3. So 20 to 22, 23 to 25, 26 to 28, 29 to 31, 32 to 34, 35 to 37, and 38 to 40. The class boundaries of 20 and 22 is 19.5 and 22.5. The class boundaries of 23 and 25 is 22.5 and 25.5. The class boundaries of 26 and 28 is 25.5 and 28.5. Class boundaries of 29 and 31 is 28.5 and 31.5. The class boundaries of 32 and 34 is 31.5 and 34.5. The class boundaries of 35 and 37 is 34.5, 37.5. And the class boundaries of 38 and 40 is 37.5, 40.5. Next is the class mark. How to get the class mark is you have to add the class interval and then divide by 2. 20 plus 22 is 42. Divided by 2, the class mark is 21. The class mark of 23 and 25 is 24. The class mark of 26 and 28 equals 27. The class mark of 29 and 31 is 30. The class mark of 32 and 34 is 33. The class mark of 35 and 37 is 36. The class mark of 38 and 40 equals 39. The tally and the frequency: 12, 9, 3, 2, 2, 1, 1 equals 30. Next is the cumulative frequency: 12, 21, 24, 26, 28, 29, 30. The percentage. Next is the percentage. How to get the percentage? The formula is frequency over summation frequency times 100. So 12 divided by 30 times 100 equals 40%. Next is 9 over 30 times 100 equals 30%. Next is 3 over 30 times 100 equals 10%. Next is 2 over 30 times 100 equals 6.67%. Next is 2 over 30 times 100 equals 6.67%. Next is 1 over 30 times 100 equals 3.33%. Next is 1 over 30 times 100 equals 3.33%. Total of 100%. And lastly, the cumulative percentage. The cumulative percentage is 40%, 70%, 80%, 86.67%, 93.34%, 96.67%, and 100%.
It is a type of graph in which a circle is divided into sectors that each represent a proportion of the whole. Upon our data set, the responses of the lifelong learners of Davao del Norte State College to the new curriculum has been categorized into 5 classes: the strongly agree, agree, neutral, disagree, and strongly disagree. For us to understand more, let's look upon the chart. This pie chart depicts that the highest percentage has been seen on the neutral class with 33%, followed by agree that has 27%, disagree with 20%, strongly agree with 17%, and strongly disagree with 3%. The result shows that most of the lifelong learners who have been the respondents of the study is in a stable manner in dealing with the new college curriculum because it gets a 33% mark that is the highest of all the responses.
Barbara!
There are two indicators that will be the main focus of the graph: the frequency and the class. For us to understand the result between the class and frequency of the lifelong learners in the new curriculum, let's look upon the graph. So the graph depicts that the highest in the class is neutral, which has the value of 10, followed by agree, which has the value of 8, disagree, which has the value of 6, strongly agree, which has the value of 5, and the lowest in the class, which has the value of 1. Meaning to say that the result shows that the highest response of the lifelong learners on the new curriculum has yielded upon the neutral class, and the lowest has yielded upon the strongly disagree class.
Pareto chart.
There are two indicators that will be used in the Pareto chart: the class and the frequency. The same also in the bar graph, but the difference in the Pareto chart is we're gonna arrange the class from lowest to highest response of the lifelong learners on the new curriculum. Let's look upon the graph. So the graph depicts that the lowest in the class has yielded upon the strongly agree, which has the value of 1, followed by strongly agree, which has the value of 5, disagree, which has the value of 6, agree, which has the value of 8, and the highest response has yielded upon the neutral class, which has the value of 10. So in other words, the result shows that the lowest class of the lifelong learners on the new curriculum has yielded upon the strongly disabled class, and the highest has yielded upon the neutral class, which has a value of 10.
Histogram.
A histogram is a graphical display of data using bars of different heights. Each bar groups numbers into ranges. A histogram helps you discover, and it also shows the underlying frequency distribution of a set of continuous data. Histogram plots in the x-axis is the frequency, and along the y-axis is the class boundaries. In histogram, taller bars show that more data falls in that range. And in the table, it shows that the taller bar is the class boundary that falls under 19.5. This is the histogram of the responses of lifelong learners in Davao del Norte State College about the new curriculum.
Frequency polygon.
Frequency polygon. A frequency polygon presents the data by using lines that connect points plotted for the frequencies at the class marks of the classes. Let us determine and understand the frequency polygon graph using the set of data represented the ages of 30 respondents of lifelong learners in Davao del Norte State College and their feedback to the new curriculum by using the group frequency distribution. To graph frequency polygon, we need the class mark and its corresponding frequency. The class mark is just the midpoint of each class by adding the lower class limit and the upper class limit, then divide it by 2. To proceed, as we see the labels on vertical axis, we have the frequency, and on the x-axis is the class mark. So in the data, we have 21, 12, 24, 9, 27, 3, 30, 2, 33, 2, 36, 1, and 39, 1. To sum up, the graph shows that the highest respondent is aging 21 and the least followed between 36 to 39 years of age.
For us to determine on how many data values lie above or below a particular value in a data set upon the separate classes, we will going to use ogive graph or cumulative frequency graph. Ogive is very similar to a histogram, only instead of rectangles, an ogive has a single point marking where the top right of the rectangle would be. Ogive plot is useful in statistics when we want to know how many observations to expect for a range of data. It allows us to quickly see how many observations were measured for all ranges less than a particular number. Ogive graph plots in the y-axis are the cumulative frequency of 0 to 30, and along the x-axis are the class boundaries, which are 19.5, 22.5, 25.5, 28.5, 31.5, 34.5, and 37.5. The graph shows that the highest cumulative frequency is the class boundary that falls under 37.5. This is the ogive graph of the responses of lifelong learners in Davao del Norte State College about the new curriculum.
The new general education curriculum has upholded the current situation of the college students. Looking upon the present placement of our dear students, lifelong learners has much endeavor upon adapting the transitional stages together with those who have passed through the said stages. On the categorical data set, the result shows that most of the lifelong learners are neutral about the said transitional stages. Looking upon the clearer picture, they have been placed themselves on a stable manner, performing and doing tasks like they were just fine in their interactions upon the students who have been through the stages. Overall, the general idea has been yielded upon the brighter face of every lifelong learner's life. Their age, or even the new curriculum, can't stop them in pushing forth through their aim, purpose, and life.
Thank you for watching!
Hope you learned something from us. Please like
and subscribe.
Enjoy!